உடலோடு உயிர் தந்து உணர்வோடு மொழி தந்து உலகெங்கும்
Yes. First, I'll answer your questions and respond to your sharings. Then I'll lead you to the next step. Next is five aspects of Sadashiva. But before that, I wanted to have some more question answers about these 11 dimensions and 25 states. Listen, 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 listen carefully. Many people had many breakthroughs. How many of you are very confident this science is working for me? So, many things have started happening. See that and see what more need to happen. Bring both and put your question. Many times, while you are putting the question, if you do not remember what is happening in you, that context, the question will be more like an intellectual, more like you are waiting to grab the mic, why you don't know, and you got the mic, let's ask. If you put what is happening in you and what you expect it to happen, then that will give a lot more light about the being you who wants answer. Understand? Come on.
From taking Karma Brahmacharya over here somewhere, the thought current of renunciation, I caught the how amazing it is, but it's like somewhere along the line, this denial thought current and this renunciation thought current got mixed. And on the day zero, you were talking about the Neo-Vedantist idea of this violent, we have a fight inside. And I was wondering if you could explain the difference between denial, renunciation, and how the whole thing leads.
Somebody came and asked me that me and my wife are not able to get along, so we both want to take sannyas. I said, you think then we are all like that? Then I told him, look around, all of them are like that, my sannyasis. Sannyas is not because you are not able to live with your wife, but because you can't share your body anymore with anybody other than Sadashiva. It became too intimate. Other than the space of Sadashiva, I can't open myself up to anything else. It's too much. That space is sannyas. Not that because I can't handle this one, let me run away and become. Understand? Sannyas is positive affirmation of your existence, not negative escapism. positive affirmation of your existence, not negative escapism. And that also needs lot of will persistence and not giving up. Not giving up.
I was reflecting as I was analyzing this polarized states of consciousness along with the length, along with the length
breath.
When I am in a relationship or I am having a meaningful conversation with somebody, is it just the state in which I am there that will define the quality of relationship or conversation I am having? Or is it that in that state, what is the extent of length, breadth and depth I have? That will decide.
No. Actually, the state in which you exist, that decides. A length, breadth, depth is always liquid. It just gets altered the moment you shift that state. Just a simple remembrance of the Guru. The intimate touch, that experience, remembrance, your whole energy will be shifted. The length, breadth, depth will be different. That is why we have in Sanskrit, Smaranat Mukti. Just by remembrance liberation. So, you don't have to bother about length, breadth, depth of that dimension, that space. The space you are in matters. Thank you, sir. How many are confident enough to do demonstration of powers? At least one. Who is, how many? How many of you are confident you can do the demonstration of at least one power? Raise your hand.
Please raise hands, whether it is for body scanning or for the remote vision.
Now I know I need to break your SDHT. Powers I have given, it's all about now breaking the SDHT. SDHT is nothing but arrogance, nothing. Okay, I'll have to work.
Hello. If you ask the question, then everyone's hands go up. Now, demo means that stage and everything,
no,
that's
no,
all
see, demo means where your arrogance need to be surrendered to me. See, they should know if I am successful, the pride is for Swamiji. If I am a failure, blame is for him. Why should I bother? There's a beautiful story. Vishnu was lying on the Vaikuntha. Mahalakshmi was pressing his feet. Suddenly Vishnu got up and started running. Mahalakshmi thought, did any demon attack Vaikuntha? Even then I have never seen in my whole life Mahavishnu running like this. And she was also chasing him and asking, "Arey, tell me, why are you running? At least tell and run. Which demon is attacking? I don't see any demon. Any attack?" Then Vishnu, without reducing the speed, the same speed running, and he's telling, look there. The Prahlada was trying his small hand and trying to show in which pillar Vishnu is there. The father is asking, Hiranyakashipu is asking, "Hey, in which pillar your Narayana is there? In this pillar or that pillar?" So the Prahlada, small kid, he is only a 5-year-old kid. When Narasimha Avatar happened, he is only 5 years, not even 6. 5 running. So that small baby is raising the hand and trying to show. Narayana says, "Whichever pillar that finger is showing, I have to get into that pillar. I can't afford to let my devotee down." It boils down there. And I will not let you guys down. There is so much of self-protection, ma. So much of arrogance and self-protection. It is arrogance. Please understand, the word is sharp, but that is the truth. Ability to throw. If I am successful, praise goes to him. Everyone knows I have not done anything. 21 days before I am, and everyone knows. And if I am not successful, blame goes to him. If I am successful, praise goes to him. Come on, let me put him in risk. No, that is the attitude. That's the only way you will move out of you. Otherwise, you are so protective of you. Here you will not even spoil the name. It is only breaking your SDHD. Anyway, I'll do it. I'll do it. I just wanted to know where the class is standing. It's a fight now between you and me. Till now it was a play field, now it's a war field.
Tatpurusha
Swami. So I have to break the arrogance. Actually, if you never get into the stage and start the demonstration, forever you will live with the idea you don't have that power. That is where the whole problem is. Because you plan and cognize you only 40% based on your thinking. You cognize about you 60% based on others' conclusion. So now the fight between this 40 and that 60. So I can neither take this side nor take that side. I have just put nuclear bomb for both. I have to break both. I'll do it. I'll do it. Initiation is play field. And now breaking your arrogance means making you open up and breaking your SDHD. See, when you are catching, when your intuition is showing, in a subtle way you get aligned. Catching what kind of alignment you are in when you are manifesting and getting back to that is what I need to do now for you guys. See, when you are manifesting the powers, you are in certain space, like your back will be a little stretched, or certain kind of a kundalini flow will be there, something will be going on in you, recreating the same just by remembering, not with any technique, just by remembering. That is what now I have to do to you guys. Then you will get the confidence. It is not even confidence, it is more like a challenging. I can't manifest powers. Let me see what you can do to me. Anyhow, I'll put you in a situation where you have to manifest this power for survival. Then you will naturally manifest and you will get confidence. That's all. I'll put you somewhere where you are completely lost. Unless you use the extraordinary powers, you will not be able to get out of the situation. Then you will be forced to use, then only then you will be able to get out of the situation. Then second time onwards, you will not ask me to put you in that situation. No, better let me manifest powers. Don't do this anymore. It'll all become all right, that's all. Come on, you do your game, I'll do my game. Let's see now.
Hello, Swamiji.
Now, that'll be a lot of fun. Lot of fun for me. Now, sometime, I think I should tell you this story. At one time, in 1999, when I sit with closed eyes, I just know I am Sadashiva. But when I open my eyes and start operating, there is one small stone kind of a thing in front of my Anandaganda, which will always hit. So I try to break that stone again and again, means manifest Sadashivatva through this body also. At one point, it became like almost Why to then have this body? Let's leave the body, because I know if I leave the body, I'll be in Sadashvatva. Unnecessarily, why struggling? I was in the banks of Narmada doing tapas. I decided to give up, leave the body, and started walking into Narmada. When water came up to the neck level, I closed the eyes and started walking. Started walking. Suddenly one rock hit at my knee and I fell. When I got up, I saw I was on the other side. When I turned, I saw that Narmada is actually considered to be a small girl. She just stood up from the river and laughed at me. And I saw that stone was missing. That's all. That stone was missing. Means that blockage was missing. So even I have to put myself in some situation where manifesting Sadashivatva becomes survival. Only then I myself manifested. So that is the only way you are going to manifest, I think. Now sometimes, even if you know you have everything, you do not want to shake the status quo. You are afraid people will make fun of you. But I tell you, people will never laugh at you if you decide and start manifesting. I tell you, I will not let you down. Anyhow, I'll do the job a little more and then I'll make it happen. I have to. You manifesting power, whether it is survival for you or not, it is survival for me. Because that is the only reason I am surviving. I am alive. Making you manifest is my responsibility more than your responsibility. Come on. Let me answer your questions, then I'll... Yes.
I've been hearing from some people about the healer's initiation that some types of seaweed are also not allowed because...
Yes.
Things like spirulina, for instance.
Understand, I'm not saying not allowed. They develop muscle memory which stops the healing energy flow in you. Anything else?
How is it a case of not having any seaweeds or yes. Certain seaweeds?
Anything which develops, some seaweeds develop muscle memory. So better to avoid.
Okay. Is there anything else that has muscle memory?
That's all I can say. Yeast.
Yeah.
Yeast develops muscle memory.
Thank you, Swamiji.
Swamiji? What's the interplay between the 25 states of consciousness and the 11 dimensions?
I should say, 25 states of the consciousness is what you perceive, you go through. 11 dimensions of universe is what universe perceives it is going through.
So if you change your state of consciousness, you'll automatically change the dimension you're in?
Yes,
and vice
sure.
Versa?
When somebody moves to Turiyadita, you will never be in length. Naturally, you will be more and more in length, breadth, depth, time, space. Surely change of consciousness leads to change of state.
But will the change in state actually lead to a change in consciousness as well?
If you yes, go... both.
Both.
Both. See, when you change, world changes. When world changes, you change.
But will a change has to be regressive? Let's say you achieved Turiyatita to Turiyatita. There's no way you'll actually go back to being deep sleep.
I should tell you, the regressive possibility completely disappears the moment you even you enter into Turiya. After that, no regressive possibility. Till Jagrat, there is regressive possibility. But not after the Turiya.